Welcome back to our YouTube channel, guys, and welcome back to another behind the sound video. My name is Ardil, and today's video is all about Wilfried Zaha's Lamborghini Aventador and the absolutely custom sound system we're upgrading it with. If you haven't done so already, make sure you've subscribed to our YouTube channel. We've already done a few videos on updates as the car came in. The first one was a product overview. Then we've been talking about kind of the build process behind the scenes on getting a system like this up and running. It is deadline day very, very shortly. So we are fully underway. James and Carla and Steve have been working on the car to get it inch perfect and getting it sounding it perfect for Wilfried Zaha as well. So what the boys are doing at the moment, what they've done already, is basically run cables through, as you can see, into this conduit. Basically what we've done is run cables from existing factory head unit all the way into the actual processor itself. Then that goes into an amplification stage sends that directly back out to the actual components themselves. So in here, we've got signals back and forth. We've also got power cables going from the battery down into the amplification stage. Obviously, in previous videos, we have touched on this already. However, inside here, we've got the Audison Bit Nove, and we've also got the Audison Voce 5.1K amplifier. This is going into a custom enclosure that still allows for the roof to actually slot into the existing positions from factory. However, everything is really, really neat and tidy. The reason why we've done this in two cable runs basically is to have the tub removable to this level. Obviously, the tub is a removable item to get to the battery. What this is basically allowing for, all these serviceable parts are still able to be accessed, and the tub just freely moves down to here, can sit on the floor, and it can go a little bit further than that. However, a really nice solution. So we're thinking not only about the actual install process today, but also future proofing if anyone else needs to work on the car at a later date. So that's basically the front end here. Inside the actual vehicle, obviously in previous videos you would have seen dashboard off. Now it's all changed. It's going back to how it should have been and how it looks now. So in terms of the door cards are back on. Behind here, we've done an immense amount of soundproofing work using the 2mm skins layer. As you can see, there's no change on the actual physical door card itself. So we've still got the Sensenum sound system grille here. The grille here is actually quite small. So the 6.5-inch driver actually forms up to about here. Reason why we put that speaker on axis is basically to get as much surface area basically of that speaker and the excursion from that cone through this grill. However, it sounds really nice and solid, and that's down to the soundproofing, down to how we've built the speaker ring, but also the Audison Thesis 6.5-inch driver down in this door. Then the main thing that we've changed on the vehicle is the actual custom A-pillars. So the custom A-pillars, basically what's involved in doing something like that, is full dashboard removal. The Thesis tweeters have been sprayed black to match in and blend in with the rest of the vehicle, and then we've retrimmed that in Milano. So they're on axis, moving that sound stage right to the driver. So Wilfried Zaha, when he's sitting in the driver's seat, sonically it's going to be inch perfect. Every detail he's going to be able to hear, plus when we tune it, which we'll be doing later on in the system once the system's up and running, what we'll actually be able to do is actually finalize every single minor detail, time align, do a full graphic EQ control, and do a hell of a lot of work on the computer to get it sounding inch perfect as well. In terms of what Carl's doing at the moment is actually integrating what's called Target Blue Eye into the factory mirror. So what he's actually doing is running a display cable up, that's the actual factory Lamborghini mirror. What Target Blue Eye is an emergency service warning device that alerts you guys on the road for all approaching emergency service vehicles that is marked and unmarked. What we're probably doing is a full final video just on Blue Eye on this car. However, we've done plenty of them already. They're already live on our YouTube channel, so make sure you go check them out. In essence, we're running cables through into factory mirror, modifying that factory mirror behind the scenes, plus then adding in the PCB wall from the actual Target Blue Eye unit into that screw, into the factory mirror, which is really cool. So there's literally nothing on display. Another thing that we've done front end of the vehicle here is actually integrated Apple CarPlay into the factory Lamborghini screen, which is really nice as well. That really utilises all the factory controls as well. So we're adding functionality as well as upgrading the sound in the vehicle. In terms of the sub, so this actually sits between the two seats here, and what we've got here is the Audison Prima 8-inch sub. So as you can see here, it blends in really nicely with the curvature of the seat, and what we've actually done is traced the outline of this design here and actually gone through and actually masked it up there, and then we've got this design here as well, which gives it a real nice feature point. It blends in really nice with the vehicle. So this is the factory Lamborghini material, then we've retrimmed this in Milano to match the actual A-pillars themselves, so that looks really smart in the vehicle. It's not too obtrusive, but also it retains the actual functionality of adding in the actual pocket. Inside there, we've actually got what's called a DRC controller that controls sub-level, but also controls the actual presets and stuff that we configure. So you've got sub-level control, you've got volume control via there as well, but obviously you've got volume control via your actual head unit as well, which is really nice. So a hell of a lot of work has gone into getting the car to this stage. Obviously in previous episodes, we focused a little bit more on the fabrication side of things, getting everything to where it needed to be for getting the dashboard back in, getting the car back together. Obviously you saw the car as it came into us, you saw it completely stripped out with the dashboard removed, seats out, the whole works. And that's what's involved in doing a sound system of this caliber on a car like this. So it's not for the faint-hearted. However, as you know, by our YouTube channel, we do a hell of a lot of these, and we do a lot of them, and there's a reason for it. People trust us to work on their cars on a daily basis of this caliber, but all sorts of other cars as well. So if you own one of these looking for a system, hopefully you've enjoyed the series. But also if you own another car looking for an upgrade, want it done properly and professionally, you know exactly what to do. Drop us a message on any of our social media platforms. I'm more than happy to go through everything with you guys, but hopefully you've enjoyed the series so far. There is more to come, so we'll be doing final videos once the car's all done, showcasing more and more about the final build product in the front, but also showcasing a little bit more about each product that we've installed with separate videos showcasing that. So make sure you stay tuned, subscribe to the YouTube channel. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching. We'll see you soon.